Welcome everyone. Here in this class we will discuss about the how a zygote will be developed into an embryo in monocots, how a monocot embryo development will take place. In the previous class we have seen the development of embryo in the dicots, how dicot embryo is developed from a zygote. Okay, so now in this video we will see how the monocot embryo will be formed. So the zygote endosperm has already been formed. Here also in monocots also embryo will be formed, will start to develop. Okay, so zygote will start to develop into embryo only after endosperm is formed. Endosperm is the nutritive tissue which provides nutrients for the growing embryo. It provides nutrients. It is endosperm is a nutritive tissue. It is rich in nutrients. So it is made just only for this growing that is developing zygote. The zygote will change into embryo. So here also after endosperm is formed, so the zygote starts undergoing changes. The zygote starts undergoing changes. So by taking the nutrition from this endosperm, the zygote which is diploid, zygote which is in diploid condition, this diploid zygote will undergo division, it will undergo mitotic divisions. It will undergo mitotic divisions. The zygote will undergo mitotic divisions. Now here meiotic divisions will be seen only during the formation of gametes. After the zygote, it repeatedly undergoes mitotic divisions till it becomes an till it changes into a individual plant. We won't see this meiotic divisions. Meiotic divisions will be seen only during the formation of zygote. So here the zygote will undergo cell division. Which cell division? Mitotic cell division. Zygote will undergo mitotic cell division and produces three cells. Zygote will undergo mitotic division and produces three cells. Here in the first one, in dicot embryo, the zygote has divided and formed two cells. That is the basal cell and the terminal cell. So here also in the zygote, this is the micropylar end. This is the collasal end. Micropylar end and the collasal end. Now here at the micropylar end, this will be the basal cell. At the collasal end, this will be a terminal cell. This will be a terminal cell, and this is the middle cell. Okay, zygote undergoes mitotic division and produces three cells. One is the terminal cell, second is the middle cell, and the one towards the micropylar end. Remember this one, because we will take this micropylan collasa as the reference. So the cell which is towards this micropyle, that will be the basal cell, and the cell which is towards the collasal end, it is called as the terminal cell, and this is the middle cell. So these three cells have been formed because of the mitotic division which has taken place in the zygote. Okay, now this middle cell will further divide and produce mass of cell. For example, this is the basal cell, so it won't give rise to any, that is any or parts. So the middle cell will divide and produce mass of cells, many number of cell. One cell will divide into two, two will divide into four, four will divide into six. So like this the middle cell also continuously divides and produces mass of cell. In the similar manner, this terminal cell will also divide and produce a mass of cell okay. So now this terminal cell will give rise to cotyledon.
the terminal cell will give rise to only one part of the seed, that is the cotyledon. Remaining all the parts, that is radical, plumule, hypocotyl, suspensor, all these are formed from this mass of cells which has been produced by the repeated division of this middle cell. So the middle cell will produce all other parts, such as this radical, plumule, hypocotyl, suspensor. All the other parts are formed by this mass of cells, which is formed because of the repeated mitotic divisions of the middle cell. So this is the, now the basal cell, it won't undergo any, it is not having any function here. So all the parts is formed by the middle cell, and one part which is formed by the terminal cell, division of the that is mass of cells which is formed from the terminal cell, is the cotyledon. And one more thing, in monocots here only one cotyledon will be formed. In the dicot embryo we have seen two cotyledons were formed. In dicot embryo two cotyledons were formed, whereas in monocot now only one cotyledon. The name itself is saying cot is cotyledon, mono is one. In monocot only one cotyledon will be seen. In the embryos of monocot only one cotyledon will be seen, whereas in the embryo of dicot, di means two, cot is cotyledons, two cotyledons will be seen in the dicot embryo, whereas in monocot embryo only one cotyledon is seen. So this one cotyledon will be arising from the mass of cell which has been produced by the repeated mitotic divisions of the terminal cell. Rest all other parts which is there in this embryo or the seed, all these other parts are formed from this mass of cells which are formed by the mitotic divisions of the middle cell. Okay, so now from this cotyledon is formed. Okay, let us see, I said you all the other parts are formed from this mass of cells of the middle cell. Now here this middle cell will further divide and changes into a structure. This further will divide and changes into a structure like this. Okay, so here few cells, when the structure it changes into a different shape and form structure like this. So here this part here, the few cells of here, this few cells will change into suspensor. This few cells will change into suspensor. Okay, now the cells which are present at this part, it will change into radical. It will change into radical. This cell, this part here, it will change into hypocotyl. It will form the cells which are present in this part, it will form the hypocotyl. And here the cells which are present here, it will change into epicotyl and plumule. It will lead to the formation of epicotyl and plumule. And this one, okay, this one changes into a cotyledon. This one changes into a cotyledon. Here in monocot, the cotyledon is called as scutellum. In dicot, we say it as cotyledons, but in monocots for cotyledon, a special name is there given, that is called as scutellum. The scutellum, which is nothing but cotyledon, it is formed from this terminal cell. Rest all these parts, plumule, epicotyl, hypocotyl, radical, everything, the suspensor. This is the suspensor here. All of which will be formed from the mass of the cells which is produced by the middle cell. Okay, now here if we see this one, so if we remove the suspensor and this basal cell, what we get is like this structure. Okay, we get a structure like this, and here
this cotyledon is very thin and papery. This cotyledon is very thin and papery. So what is the function of cotyledon actually? It stores the reserve food material. The cotyledon stores the reserve food material inside the seed. The cotyledons will be there. They will store the reserve food material for the embryo. Okay, so now this is the embryonal axis. This is the embryonal axis. Now here this part is the hypocotyle. Okay, from here the cotyledon arises. So this part, from where the cotyledon arises, this is the cotyledonary node. Part from where the cotyledon arises, this is the cotyledonary node, and just the part which is above the cotyledonary node, this part is called as epicotyle. Okay, and this part is the plumule, and this part is the radical. This part is the radical. Now radical give rise to root system of the plant. Radical give rise to root system of the plant, whereas plumule give rise to shoot system of the plant. Radical give rise to root system of the plant, plumule give rise to shoot system of the plant. Plumule will be towards the collasal end, and radical will be towards the micropylar end. And from this radical, the roots will start to arise, and from this plumule, the shoots will start to, that is, the shoot will arise, stem, branches and all will arise from this plumule. Okay, but here in this monocot seed, in a monocot embryo, here this plumule, I said you, this cotyledon, it is given a special name, that is scutellum. Okay, scutellum, this is thin and papery. This is thin and papery. It will have very less reserve food material. It will have very less food material. Now here this plumule will be covered by a sheath. I'll put it with this black here. This plumule will be covered by a sheath. Okay, and this radical will also be covered by sheath. Both the plumules and radical, both the plumule and radical, both of them will be covered by the sheath. Okay, so now this sheath, this plumule with this sheath, this is called as coleoptile. The sheath which is at the plumule, this plumule with the sheath, this is the coleoptile, and this sheath which is covering the radical, this is coleorhiza. Okay, three different terms which we see. This plumule, epicotyle, cotyledonary node, hypocotyle, everything will be there in the dicot as well. Okay, this cotyledon will also be there, but here in this monocots, different name is given for the cotyledon, and that name is scutellum. And in dicots now, the cotyledons are very rich in reserve food material. They are fleshy, swollen, fleshy, they are that is filled with reserve food material, whereas in monocot, cotyledon is present, but it is very thin and papery and with very little reserve food material, with very little reserve food material. Okay, this radical will be covered by sheaths, that is called as coleorhiza, and this plumule will be covered by the sheath, that is called as coleoptile. So three different terms: coleoptile, coleorhiza, and the scutellum. So scutellum is nothing but cotyledon only, but the cotyledon of monocot, which is thin and papery, that is called as scutellum. This coleoptile is nothing but the sheath which is present at the plumule. So the plumule with the sheath is coleoptile, and radical with the sheath is coleorhiza. Radical with the sheath is coleorhiza. So this is how the embryo, this is the embryonal axis, and this is the whole embryo. Okay, so this will be seen in the seeds. This is the embryo, monocot embryo, which will be seen in the seeds. In monocots now, here the seeds are endospermic. In dicots, almost the seeds are non-endospermic, that is non-endospermic in the sense till the embryo is totally formed, the endosperm will be finished. There will be very little endosperm or no endosperm will be present. So those almost all the monocot seeds are non-endospermic seeds. So endosperm, which is formed before the development of the zygote, so that will be totally utilized during this formation of the dicot embryo, and the seed which is formed from this, the ovule which changes into seeds, it have very less or no endosperm. Okay, but here in monocots the seeds are almost endospermic. In almost all monocots the seeds are endospermic, that is all the seeds have endosperm in it. So endosperm, which is formed during this before this development of zygote, that endosperm will be present in monocots. Okay, it will be present because this cotyledon is very thin and papery, it has very less food material. Then how will this embryo survive? So to make this embryo survive, this is the monocot seeds will be having endosperm in it. Okay, so reserve food material will not be stored in this cotyledon, it will be stored in the embryo. So monocots here in grasses, you find this one, the cotyledon in grasses is the scutellum, that is monocots. Grasses are monocots. You find this type of embryo in grasses, and in this maize is also monocot. Maize, corn, it is also a monocot. If we take the seed of the maize, this will be the seed of the maize. So here this maize, na, at this base you will find this some when we see this chip, when we chew the maize, na, or maize, so here in the inside the maize, na, you will find one small seed like one structure. So basically here at this, here we find this, this is this one, this is the scutellum, and this is the coleorhiza, this is the coleoptile, this is the epicotyle, this is the cotyledonary node, this is the hypocotyle, and this is the radical. So at this, here the embryo will be present, and this will be the fleshy endospermic part. What we eat here is the special endospermic part. This is the endosperm will be present in the seed. So here this cotyledon will have very little reserve food material. So when the embryo needs food, na, the endosperm will be digested and it will be gone inside this cotyledon, and from this cotyledon the new endosperm will go into the embryo. So in monocot seeds the cotyledon does not store the reserve food material, very little reserve food material will be there, but endosperm will be there. So almost all monocot seeds are endospermic seeds. All monocotyledonous seeds are endospermic seeds. So we will discuss this one, and here when we discuss this monocot and dicot seeds, so this is how the development of embryo takes place in the monocot. Okay, so we have seen how dicot embryo is formed and monocot embryo is formed. Now in the next class we will see the structure of monocot seed as well as the dicot seed.